Hey, what's up guys, it's Kaustopia, and today we will be taking a look at the MSM Extended version 11, which is a custom ROM based upon Android 10 for the OnePlus 3T. And guys, as per the drill, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my videos. So let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So firstly guys, taking a look at the ROM info. As always, we go into the about info of the phone here, and in firmware info, as you can see, this is the MSM extended version 11 official build of the ROM. This is the latest build that is released on July 12th. Android version is 10. It is Android 10 based custom ROM, so that's a great thing. Then the main Android security patch level is July 5, 2020. So that's the latest security patch. And talking about the kernel, it has its own generic kernel. I don't have the info about the kernel. So that's about it for the ROM info. Coming to the second thing, guys, is the display and the ROM customizations. So here again, I will go into the settings, into display. Then here we get all the basic settings which we expect from every Android 10 ROM. But surprisingly, we don't have the dark mode option right here. It is inside the settings, inside the ROM customization settings. Basically, the only new feature that I see here is screen attention. So basically, this is like whenever you will be looking at the phone display will stay on, but it will drain your battery, so just don't use it. Then the next thing is gaming driver preferences. So this is also a new setting. Like basically, this is hidden in each and every ROM, but surprisingly, this is given directly in the display settings. So that's a nice thing to boost your gaming performance. So yeah, that's about for the display customizations. And now I will go into the ROM customization. So here, as we can see, we have a separate tab, extensions tabs, and here we get all the customizations that we might ever need. And guys, this ROM is especially known for its customization features that it offers. Then in theme room here, if we go guys, here we get the dark mode option. So we have a lot of dark mode options: Google dark, pitch black. I have now set it to pitch black, which looks absolutely great on this AMOLED display. Then accent and gradient picker. Guys, this two options have a problem, which I will tell you further in the video, so do watch the video till the end. Coming to the third thing guys, is face unlock and volt. So face unlock is present by default on this ROM. That's a nice thing that I'm seeing, that every Android 10 ROM developer is including face unlock in their ROMs. And talking about network guys, then we have a working VoLTE. So as you guys can see, I have got the VoLTE logo on the top right here. VoLTE is working absolutely fine, so I've turned on VoLTE right here. With the fingerprint sensor, there is a bug. Like if your phone is in sleep mode, like for a longer period of time in deep sleep mode, then the fingerprint scanner just stops working. Like it also goes into deep sleep, that's why it doesn't detect your fingerprint, but it happens only rarely. So face unlock will always save you if that happens. So face unlock is also there. Coming to the stock launcher of this ROM guys, so by default this ROM comes with the CRDroid launcher, which is quite surprising. And in the original CRDroid ROM 6.8, it was crashing a lot. I was to get system UI crashes, but in this one guys, it's working absolutely fine. I didn't have any random freeze or crash with this one. We have got all the basic customization options here. Not a lot of them are present in the stock launcher. You can always go for Nova launcher is what I would suggest. But guys, there is one big issue, and that is with the accent color, which I previously told you. So here in theme room, if I show you, this is the accent color which I've chosen, that is the blue teal color. And this color keeps on displaying throughout the UI randomly. Like randomly you will get blue bars somewhere or the other. Like in Spotify, I can show you that. So in Spotify, if I play any music right now, I have kept this on. So as you can see, the background is completely is the accent color which it has picked. So by default it should be black, but surprisingly, the due to this ROM bug, I'm getting the accent color all over the background of this Spotify player. So talking about the next thing guys, is the camera performance. And as always, it all the ROMs, Android 10 ROMs, mostly come with this shitty AOSP camera, which is not that great enough. And as always, I suggest you to install Gcam mod 7.3. so right now I have installed the Gcam mod 7.3 and just use it in HDR enhanced mode, you will get some excellent pictures. Talking about the benchmark guys, then I have tried out AnTuTu benchmark here. So this is the score that I got. which is 1,97,113. So that's the score that we get. So if you guys are, some of you guys were really interested in Antutu scores, so this is the benchmark. And guys, benchmark just don't translate to real world performance. They are just numbers, guys. Real world performance matters a lot compared to this numbers. So yeah, so this is the Antutu score for this MSM extended version 11 custom ROM. Talking about the battery life, guys, then it's also pretty good enough, I should say. I was getting around approx 3.5 to 4 hours of SOT on a normal usage. So here in the battery menu, if we see, then we get the battery saver, adaptive batteries present, and this ultra power saving is something I really liked. Basically, when you turn it on and when your screen goes off, then your phone will be put into complete deep sleep hibernation, due to which it will kill all the processes and keep your phone in deep sleep. That way your battery will get saved. So finally, guys, concluding the video, my opinion about this ROM is that it has a lot of customization features. So if you want a customization feature packed ROM, then you should go for this. But I would not suggest you to daily drive this ROM, guys, because as I told you previously, mentioned about this accent color bug that I am getting. Like, you get accent color bars anywhere, the accent color just goes throughout the UI, like it is a system-wide application of accent color. So that's one bug which I faced, and that is a UI bug, like it will not affect your daily use. But then too, guys, that's one bug is there. And if you want, you can also definitely try this ROM out. It has a lot of customization features, and see if it works out for you. So yeah, so that's about it for this video, guys. I hope you guys like this video, and if you like it, please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more awesome content. This is your boy Kaustubia from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.